So good afternoon, and it's good to see all of you after this 1.5 days, almost 2 days, all looking quite, you know, focused and still charged. The topic given to us was role of learning in innovation and creating new business models. And when I got this topic, you know, I remembered of a story that my mother used to tell me. That there was this young boy who had to appear for a test. And he was given the understanding that the language test, the essay would be on a cow. So he practiced of an essay of a cow. And he said the cow has 2 horns, 4 legs, 2 ears, and things like that. And he practiced and he made a beautiful essay. And when he went to the exam hall, he got a question, said, write an essay on a river. And then he said, what do? I've prepared for the essay on cow. So he wrote, there was a river, and it had 2 banks. And on one of the bank, there was a green field. And on the field, there was a cow. And the cow had 2 horns, and 2 ears, and a tail. So I hope we'll be able to touch on the subject of innovation somewhere along this presentation. A little bit of introduction, and I won't take much time on this, is we have got about 30 years of corporate existence. We've been leader almost from the start, making about 4,000 cars per day. We normally take about 12 hours to make a car, but if you look at the total throughput, that's about 12 seconds per car. There are 4 plants in 2 locations, and currently we have the largest installed capacity. Last year we produced 1.1 million cars. And we have the largest network of sales and service. The mission was to produce economic cheap cars and motorize the entire country. And that, I think, we have been, still our mission goes on. This is a vision. The vision has a short and clear purpose, to be leader in the Indian auto industry and creating delight for the customer. When I was looking at this subject, you know, learning linked to innovation, and then I had a small discussion with my team that what would mean by, you know, innovation in learning. And what struck to us is that it's like the 6 blind men of Hindustan that goes to see the elephant. And one of them touches the trunk and says, elephant is like a pillar. One touches the tail, says like a rope. One touches the tusk and says, this is a pointed, you know, very sharp thing. And one touches the ear and says, this is like a fan. But what we could make out is probably the business needs, such as legislation, customer requirements, demanding customer requirements, focusing on quality and cost, and a continuous improvement process would be some of the things that would lead to innovation and change. Before we proceed further, I'd like to try and connect how learning and development connects with the innovation that happens. So what do you do in our company? We have, instead of doing approach, I said, what are the events that we do? So we have a senior board level retreat. That's a 2-day retreat. And the interesting part of the retreat is what they discuss over there is business. It's an HR organized retreat and business is discussed. Challenges are discussed. Customers, the stakeholder expectations are discussed. Stakeholders are, the customers, the suppliers, the employees, the dealers, the government, the society, and they discuss on what are the expectations and what business needs to do. Then we have a 2-day workshop for the divisional heads who are next in line, the AVPs. This is once in a year, centered around strategic leadership, innovation, developing others. The third one, the DPM's roundtable, is a more interesting one. In fact, what happens here is a discussion. Various business verticals come, whether it's marketing and sales, whether it's supply chain, production, and they'll come and present what are their business plans in accordance with what are the business challenges. So there are business challenges and they have business plans for that. They would discuss that, they would present it to the group over there, consisting of one lot like this, 60, 70 people. And there would be questioned and there would be a discussion on what they're doing. And focused based on this question and answer, there the groups would be formed of these people, the department heads, which would go into actual learning projects. Junior management, we train very much like I think what the rest of the industry does, other industries do. And supervisory, it's a leadership program. So the simple question is, if a diploma holder at the age of 25 has to manage workmen at the age of 35, why would a workman respect him? So that's a simple question that we would ask. Why would a workman respect you, and how do you gain that respect? Then we have the overseas training, which leads to the R&D impact, the research and development impact. And we have QC and Kaizen interventions, a typical Japanese approach to continuous improvement. I'll be covering this more as I go along. So what happens? I was talking about the action learning projects. Out of all this, especially the DPM's roundtable and the senior leader workshops, we form action learning projects. These are projects that are taken based on these discussions. The discussion is on a business challenge. There is a group has to identify a solution. The solution is identified. We take people from cross-functional team from marketing, supply chain, production, production engineering, QC. So you have a wide range of people from human resource. And they will then, take a particular issue and evolve solutions for those issues. We take this also to the Agni Forum. Agni Forum is a board-level presence where they would make a presentation to the board, make a pitch for it, and say, this is what we have in mind, this is what we'd like to do. And the outcome of that pitch or presentation would be a go or a no-go. A go would mean you go ahead and do the project, try it out and see what happens. No-go would mean it is shelved right there. If there's a budget requirement, that budget requirement would also be given. But normally we're doing some or other activities, related activities, and people from those areas would join in that particular CFT and take this forward. For the research and development, we have trained over 1,000 people in Japan. We have been sending them from a period of 1 year, 2 years as trainees, and then they would go back and work further 1 or 2 years as work permit. Under the work permit scheme, where they would actually work, be an employees of Suzuki Motor Corporation, and they would do hands-on designing, all aspects of designing. And this sort of learning on the job is the transfer of technology that has happened. And we have ramped this up. Out of this, one-third is last 3 years. So if you see 20 years, it was 1,000, but last 3 years. And we have also ramped up our engineering from 400 people to around 1,200 people in the last 5-6 years. So that's another focus area. And then we have the shop floor, quality circle, and suggestion schemes that goes on. So what are experiences, what has happened because of this action learning projects and other approaches, what we have been able to do? If you look at, I'll talk about five initiatives that has worked, and there are other initiatives that have worked, but I thought this five would, be a good sample. More feet on street is more to do with our marketing activity. The rural dealer sales executive concept is also to do with marketing activity. I'll expand on each of them. Third component is the production component, and the fourth one is the R&D capability or the R&D component, and the fifth one is an HR component, which we call the Human Resource Initiative Development Committee. So look at the first one, more feet on street. Somewhere in 2005, based on this action learning projects, we realized that we must focus more on the customer and that we have to create a presence right there when the customer is required, where we can actually have a smaller geographical spread, we can be closer to the customer, and we can decentralize our decision making. So this basically increased the pace in the field of decision making, and we doubled our, the regional offices from 8 to 16, and we made it a two-tier system, decentralizing and empowering over right in the field, the decision making process. If you look at the rural marketing concept, what happened basically is we as car sellers were waiting at our showrooms for customers to come to us and buy. So there are, sales executives sitting at dealer showrooms waiting for customers to come by seeing an ad or gaining some interest or word of mouth. So the idea came, why not we put a person in a village, and maybe he's from that village only, appoint him as a rural sales executive, give him training, and all he requires is a 300 square feet area, some shop, and where he can, have the pamphlets and the posters. And then once in a while, we can do a car display. This increased our reach tremendously, and there are over now 3,000 rural sales executives who are based in small villages. If you look at the production example, this is one activity which our production business vertical runs, and there's a total focus on TTC, the Technical Training Center. And out of this learnings of the technical training centers, we have implemented 475 projects that are on low automation, on making, you know, reduction in operator fatigue, or something very simple in trying to simplify the operation and improving the productivity. All this has resulted in our suggestion scheme, which has an impact of almost 3 lakh suggestions a year that has been generated from 10,000 employees, and a cost saving of roughly around 300 crores. And it's a quite a significant and important impact. If you look at the R&D initiative, we had taken a business strategy that will produce one new model every year, and this came through our an initiative or our intention to retain our market share. And all these people who go abroad, who get trained, I was talking about this, 1 year, 2 year, as trainees they go, and then they go under work permit scheme. They get hands-on experience, and we have been launching one new model every year. And I think the design of Swift, our people are very much there when it was designed in Japan, and the Alto 800 is almost an independent activity. As we progress each year, the capability to design is increasing. This is something that will, I think, interest all of us here. When we form HR policies, it's possible that we have a disconnect with business. It is possible that once we deploy a policy, there is a lot of, unhappiness, whether it's a travel policy or a leave policy. Once that is done, so we typically say this is a three-man in a room syndrome, where three men together from HR get up and make a, sit in a room and discuss and make a policy, which is not actually accepted by the line functions of business. So we have, started this forum where we have the top management, the senior management, and each HR policy suggestions that we have. In fact, we did this last session yesterday morning at 9:30 at a factory where we presented what we wanted to do in various areas, whether it was, a telephone reimbursement or a higher education approach, or if you're looking at executive coaching, what is our take on that. And then the entire group there actually acts as a sounding board. They give their suggestions. They tell you what would not work and what would work. We have taken this further to a junior committee, where they also not only act as a sounding board, but they help us implement projects. They also work on, they also give a Gen Y perspective, and they help us implement these projects. They also help sharing the information down the line. So we call it Human Resource Initiative Development Committee 2. I think finally at the end, I'd like to share Vijay Govindarajan's, the model of business strategy and innovation of Box 1, Box 2, Box 3. And how it, he has explained things over there is that there are three things that we can normally do. One is managing the present. The other is the adjacent space to the present. And the third is creating the future. We are all focused on our immediate business, immediate activity. We spend most of our time there. And that's natural. And that's one of the box. Not only we are in, we get trapped in that box. The second possibility could be the adjacent space. For us, it could be the finance venture that we did. We introduced Maruti Finance, Maruti Insurance. Still related to our core business, but it's apart. It's not making of cars. And if tomorrow we would go into making of buses, say, then probably it would be a box two. Box three would be a totally separate something out of line. So if you'd go to real estate or some other business for Maruti, that would be box three. And most of the innovations, most of the initiatives that I've shown you are either in box one or some of them are in box two. So I think there is a message in here for us that how do we look at creating more box two and sometimes box three innovations that we should work on. Thanks, that was all I had, and remember always to buy Maruti cars.